Trucking, Konica Minolta, Nutrien Ag Solutions, Pattison Outdoor Advertising, Plains Midstream, Sask Barley, Save-On Foods, Showtime Event and Display, Sweet Pro, The Atlas Hotel, Versatile, Viterra, and Weaver Livestock. Thank you very much.
We would also like to thank Co-op, the official fuel provider of Canadian Western Agribition. Thank you. Comments from our judge on the Shorthorn side.
This split of bred heifers, we start off the class with a heifer that's you really got to admire the power and performance of this heifer. You stand back and analyze her. She's very, very soft-sided, deep-sided female, very stout made, very good in her lines. The heifer gets out and moves very, very well. One thing we'd maybe like to know, tick a condition off this heifer, she is a little chubbier, but for as chubby as she is, she gets out and moves very, very well. She's a very nice female. Get into a roan heifer in second, a very nice female as well, a very fresh female. Female catches your eye when she comes on the ring. She's got adequate amount of softness. A heifer that's got a lot of length of body. She gets out and moves very well. Udder development's coming nicely on this female. I believe she's going to have a nice level udder with nice teat size. A heifer maybe just gets outpowered by the heifer in front of her here today, but a very good female in her own right. I get into a red heifer in third. Again, another heifer, very soft-sided kind of female. Female's got some stoutness, some sogginess. Looks like she's going to go out and make an excellent cow. A female maybe just gives up a little bit of that overall structure, and I appeal to the heifers above her. I get into a heifer in third. Again, long-bodied female. Female's got enough depth of body. Female that maybe just gives up the stoutness and the cleanliness up through that front end of the heifers above her here today.
Thank you for your comments. First in the class was 3138, Murraydale J, 34F. Exhibited by CLF and RSB Cattle Company, additional owner of Ramrod Cattle Company. In second was 3144, Bell M Isle, 121F, exhibited by Bell M Farms. In third was 3143, Lingley's Ruby, 33F, exhibited by Lingley Livestock. And rounding the class out was 3140, South River Fancy 1F, exhibited by South River Shorthorns. Coming into the ring now, our females born January 1st to February 28th, 2018.
Steve. lot of give and take in this class here. This heifer that wins the class, though, I think the back two-thirds of this heifer are ideal, and I don't really mind the front third that much either. I'd maybe like to tone her down just a little bit up through her head, and she's got just a little bit there in her jowl, but I actually like a lot of things about that because her body matches it so well. She's extremely cowy. She's extremely sound. A lot of substance to this heifer. She's good back through her hip. She's just a very, very fault-free type of a heifer. You're going to find some prettier. The heifer here in second and the heifer in third in some ways are prettier than this heifer, but they don't fit together as well as this heifer. And she is one that catches your eye when she comes out. And the more you study this heifer, the more you really appreciate her, just how fundamentally great she really is. She's good on her feet and legs. I like her body. I like the composition they have her in right now. I like how she's made back through her hip. I think she's a heifer that's got a lot to her now, but also has a lot of future. The heifer here in second, I like a lot of things about. I think down the road, this will be a tough heifer to get around. She gets outpowered and just outmassed and outbodied this class winner here, and I think with that, she's a little bit more narrow constructed underneath. I like the youthfulness of this heifer. I like how clean she is in terms of her composition for right now. I just like to power her up and pull her apart a little bit to find herself higher. She's more refined for sure than this heifer here in third. A very well presented, extremely well shown heifer here. The problem for me is she's just a little bit too much. She's a little too tight when you get her to go off that front end and back through her spine. She's a huge heifer relative to this class. I'd like to tone her down just a little bit. I think she's a heifer that's got a tremendous amount of good, and she does catch your eye as much as any of them when you come out here. The more you study her, the straighter she wants to get off that front end. Like I say, she's just a little bit tighter in her top and back through her hip, but a very nice heifer with some really outstanding pieces. The heifer here in fourth is just a little bit quicker pattern. She doesn't have the length of the heifers in the head of her. I like a lot of things about this heifer in terms of her depth. She's bold sprung. She's got some mass to her. She's really good up through that front end as well. She just gets a little bit shorter strided, especially off the hind too. The heifer here that follows her doesn't have as much shape and hip as some of the heifers up ahead of her, but I think she struggles just a little bit more off of her hind end when you ask her to move. A little bit more restricted off of her hind legs, and I would think with that she can get a little more narrow-chested. Doesn't have the bone of some of the heifers ahead of her. I like a lot of things about her maternally. I like how she's made up through that head and neck and the length she's got to her. She's just deeper and bolder sprung, too, than this heifer that follows her. This heifer's just a little bit flatter ribbed to me. When you get off of her, she's a little bit more straighter underneath in terms of just being a little bit more tubular. Exceptionally long over her top and back through her hip. Just like to pull her apart. This heifer here that follows her does have more shape. The problem is today she's not wanting to move. She's too straight off those hind legs for me, and that carries up into her hip. I'd like to relax her just a little bit and make her more comfortable. Looks like she took the trip a little tough. She's just more restricted than what I think's ideal. This heifer here is a little more fluent off of her hind end, but she's the flattest made heifer in the class. I'd like to pull her apart and give her more shape and just a little bit more quality throughout.
Thank you, Judge Hoffman. Our results from Class 4E. First in class was WCC 100B Jessica 9100G, exhibited by Wescana Cattle Company. In second, Moorhaven 117E Sarah 8G, exhibited by Moorhaven Farms, Curtis and Cole Hewitt, and Medonte Pold Herfords. In third, JM Nutrend Stormy ET 1G, exhibited by JM Nutrend Cattle Company. In fourth, MHPH HF 646D Style 108G, exhibited by Arthur Pold Herfords and Medonte Pold Herfords. In fifth, Stonewood Chantel 1G, exhibited by Stonewood Grange, Golden Oak, and AXA Farms. In sixth, GH Rock Gypsy Delight ET 10G, exhibited by Nelson Hershey Purebreds. In seventh, MHPH 646D Nita 105G, exhibited by Medonte Pold Herfords. In eighth, XLP 73S Daydream ET 149G, exhibited by Lone Pine Cattle Services. Now in the ring is your pole champion senior division heifer calf class. And in the ring, from class 4A, you have Glenlee's JC 8Y Daisy 20G. Reserve in that class with CCR 36N Unforgettable 60G. From class 4B, you have HMS Highcliff 225D Glamour 32G and Harvey Miss Firefly ET 75G. From class 4C, you have CCR 7057 Kesha 14G and MHPH 68E Nita 203G. From class 4D, you have Harvey Miss Firefly 22G and ANL CTO 206E Stephanie 17EC 22G. From class 4E, you have WCC 100B Jessica 9100G and Moorhaven 117E Sarah 8G.
On the short horn side, it looks like they have blended the split one and split two of the females born January 1st to February 28th, just if you're following along in the book. We will have some comments from our judge on the Shorthorn Yearling Heifer class.
We apologize for taking a little more time in this class. It's a very difficult class. And for those of you in the stands watching, it's going to look like it's kind of up and down and big and little. But that's just the way it has to be today. We all have cows at home, and we have some good little cows, and we have some good big cows. The heifer we started the class with is probably the most moderate heifer in the class, but a heifer that puts it all together. She's very, very attractive in her makeup. A heifer's very deep-sided and carries that all the way through. A heifer's very nice through that hip structure. A heifer probably would put her above the heifer in second, as we're thinking, we feel the udder maybe going to be a little more square on this heifer in second or in first hole. Heifer, we feel, has got a lot of future in the breed, a very nice female. Get into a red heifer in second, a heifer we really, really admire this female. She's a power female, very long-sided. For as big as she is, she's very, very fresh. Heifer, you get in behind her, she's very stout, she's very deep-sided, she moves very, very well. Maybe just like to space those teats a little differently, but these are bred heifers, and a lot can change between now and the time they lay down and have a calf, but that's what put her in second here today. Get into white heifer here in third, a very attractive female. A heifer that gets on moves very, very well. A heifer that maybe just gives up a little bit of that overall power to the heifers above her in the class today. And that's why this heifer had to be in third hole. Get into a roan heifer in fourth. A very long-bodied female. A female you got to really admire for the stoutness this female has. She maybe just gets a little more tubular in her makeup. A female that maybe just could be a little softer through that lower third to be any higher in this class here today. Get into a red heifer in fourth. Heifer, you really got to admire the length of body of the female and the way she gets out and moves around the ring. A female is setting down a nice udder. Just like to see a little more stoutness and a little more style to be any higher in the class today. Get into a big red heifer in fifth hole. Very long-bodied female, female with adequate...